This is the reinforcements the Space Rebels promised us?
Last we heard, they were ambushed by the Imperial fleet in the Rigel system.
I'll give him permission to dock.
Do you think the stories are true?
Wizards from deep space? Highly skeptical.
I am Luke Skywalker, Jedi Knight and friend.
Welcome to the International Space Station. I am Vladimir Titov of Roscosmos.
I'm Sally Ride, and this is Mae Jemison and Nassen. It's a pleasure to meet you, Commander Skywalker.
You can call me Luke.
Well, Luke, a garrison of Rebel soldiers arrived in LEGO City 2 days ago. The princess is meeting with the Master Builders.
The princess? She's here?
Yes. She said you have the plans to the Empire's new super weapon?
Hey, R2?
If we can get this robot to the Master Builders, they may be able to find a weakness.
Hey everyone, a massive object just appeared on the radar.
Very bad feeling about this.
Hurry, we need to get down to Earth.
Vader.
Come on, let's go.
I want to know what happened to the plans they sent you.
Never.
Then you will die.
Hey, Star Devil, you talking about these plans?
All too easy.
Przyszczaj Kosmiczycki, demon.
What?
Sally has escaped with the robot. We best get out of here before...
Who's there?
Luke! It's me! The Clown Prince of Crime! And also your father.
Father,
I love you.
Farm Boy was easier to trick than you anticipated.
No one's who you think they are, my dear.
Hey, Pennywise, let go of him.
In you come, boys! I've softened them up, boy.
I'm back.
Crucios! Encore! More! Bravo!
So this is Earth's first line of defense? I can only imagine how simple conquering the humans will be. We must prepare for invasion.
Well, we re-entered somewhere north of Europe. This is a strange place. Sorry, little bot. I don't quite understand you. Is that binary you're beeping? Well, we better get moving. The Master Builders need you. Well, I'll be...
Why, hello there, mistress.
I'm Sally Ride. I'm on a quest to...
Dory, Nori, Ori.
Healy.
Healy.
Dwalin. And Bifor.
At your service.
And I am Thorin Oakenshield, son of Thorn. We too are on a quest. A great evil is amassing in the east. War is on the horizon. We have traveled many moons from the Iron Hills to join the armies gathering at LEGO City.
LEGO City, that's where I'm heading. I have important information for the Master Builders.
Why, we happen to be traveling with a Master Builder, the great wizard Gandalf the Grey.
Mr. Gandalf, this robot holds plans to the enemy's superweapon. If there's any hope for good in this world, I have to bring it to LEGO City.
I will help you bear this burden, my lady.
Welcome aboard the company, Miss Ride.
You all right there, R2?
Lego
City is
3 days' ride at all speed.
3 days? The city will have fallen by then.
It's them, Harry. The invaders.
Expelling.
Stop! They're just dwarves.
What sorcery are these flying children?
There are wizards in this world.
Are you a wizard too? Would you happen to know Albus Dumbledore?
He's a very old friend.
Who are these invaders you're talking about?
At first it was just the goblins coming down from the mountains, but now they're here.
Dumbledore says the battle of our age is upon us.
Listen here, I'm carrying the plans for that Star Wars weapon. We have to bring it to Lego City. Is there any way you could fly us there?
Not alone, but our friends can help.
I'll go to the Gryffindor common room and let everyone know.
And I'll get Hagrid. We'll be right back. You'll be in Lego City soon.
Sir, Tetton's squadron has found Lord Vader in orbit. Should we dispatch a shuttle to retrieve him?
I will have to discuss his retrieval with the new boss. Mr. Joker, shall we retrieve Lord Vader?
Don't you worry. Your new master's coming home. Guys! It's great to see you!
Do you bring news, I trust?
Yes. I have here the daily Imperial News update. First off, the Empire would like to thank the Daleks for bringing us together from the various corners of time and space. We would also like to thank Darth Malgus for summoning the Sith Lords of the past 1,000 generations to join our cause. And a special thanks to Ogle for providing the meeting with seafood. Now, we have sent the Master Builders an ultimatum, demanding that Lego City either be surrendered or marched upon by our armies. They have yet to acknowledge the message.
Additionally, our new Death Star is fully operational.
In the unlikely event that the city cannot be taken, the super laser will destroy Earth, wiping out any remaining resistance to our combined empires.
Wir haben den Totenstern. Ich sage, wir zerstören jetzt den Planeten. Warum Soldaten verschwenden die Lego-Stadt angreifen?
Oh yes, but think of the fun.
But for a more tactical reason, Lego City serves as a symbol of freedom throughout the universe. To destroy it with the Death Star would ignite uprisings across the galaxy, but to take and hold the city by military force would be a true sign of victory.
Once we reach the planet's surface, we will attack from multiple directions. Our technological advantages will allow us to punch through the remaining defenders, seize its control center, and disable the shields protecting it from orbital bombardment.
Arg, and what be of the lass who fled with the Death Star plans?
That's one of my mission parameters.
Ye scallywag thinks ye can stop her?
Course, I'm a Terminator.
Ich mag diesen Mann. Any questions?
Yes, just who put you in charge?
Something on your mind?
What we have here is a gathering of the most maniacal minds in history. Alone we have achieved great evil deeds. Mola Ram, you've enslaved children in a mine, worship the devil, and can tear out a man's beating heart with your bare hands. Agent Smith, you kept all humanity imprisoned in a simulation so that robots could feed off their life force. Anubis, god of death. Let me be the first to say I am a huge fan. As Lord of the Underworld, you assure human suffering is not just restricted to life.
And Tojo, don't even get me started.
There are gods among us, great military dictators, and yet, in the absence of Darth Vader, we allow a clown to take command?
He's nothing more than a deranged man in makeup.
You're not evil, just crazy.
And what's wrong with that?
Joker, I demand you step down and allow me to lead this campaign, or I'll have to remove you myself.
If you wanted so badly, you only had to ask.
Be a lamb and sweep out the trash. You know, kids, I'm ready to give this old town a wedgie. I have to know you're with me. Will you say it for me one time?
We're with you.
A little louder.
We're with you.
Excellent.
Let's start the party.
You heard him. Ready your forces. There will be no one to stop us.
We should be arriving soon.
There it is! Lego City!
Gandalf the Grey, please enter.
Gandalf, I'm pleased you made it.
Moses, it's been too long.
Neil Armstrong, it's good to see you. Not the circumstances, but...
I understand. It's good to see you too, Sally.
Come, friends, there is much to discuss.
Artu, it is you!
What do you mean, what's all the fuss? We thought you were doomed!
Artu! Let's hope these plans work.
It'll work.
I come with tidings in this dark hour, and with counsel.
Gandalf, my fellow master builder, you have traveled far to be here for a moment of great import.
The enemy has overwhelmed us on every front. We have nowhere left to retreat to. Our only option is to dig in here and make this city our last stand.
And risk the lives of the people? If the citizens are to have any chance, we must make this an open city.
I disagree, Athena. We cannot sacrifice Lego City to the enemy.
If it is captured, the armies of darkness will march all over the face of the earth.
The enemy forces are converging 30 kilometers east of Lego City. It will take several hours before they launch their attack.
I propose we strike before the enemy has an opportunity.
It is critical we send an attack group there and...
Waste the mother...
Corporal Hicks, what is your opinion of an advanced attack on the enemy forces?
That's worth a try, but we don't even know if it's going to affect
them.
Come on, guys. How about we don't fight and just have peace?
Yeah, maybe all you need is love.
Joker has threatened to bomb the city and enslave the population if we don't give in to his demands of surrender.
Oh, well, that's like... totally not cool.
Even if we have to hold the city, there's the looming threat of the Galactic Empire super weapon.
What sort of weapon is it?
A Death Star. We fought this technological terror before, but only after it destroyed my home planet.
So they built a second?
Actually, this is the Death Star 7. The Daleks brought it back in time from the future Star Wars Episode 13.
Okay, how do we blow it up? There's always a way to do that.
Analysis of the plans provided by Sally Ride reveal a thermal exhaust port that leads directly to the Death Star's main reactor. If we can trigger a nuclear explosion within this exhaust port, the blast will trigger a chain reaction, destroying the main reactor and the entire station with it.
That's the same way we destroyed the last one. You mean after 12 episodes, the Empire still can't build a proper Death Star?
9 episodes. You don't know it, Princess, but you're actually living in Episode 4.
I would offer a blockade runner, but it's far too large to slip past the Death Star's defenses.
What of the starships in your Alliance fleet?
We escaped an attack by Star Destroyers, but for all we know, the fleet is still pinned down in the Rigel system.
They're out there somewhere. Lead us onto the relay satellite.
It's worth a shot. R2, try to boost the satellite's signal range. The signal's too weak.
I hate to ask, but is your civilization capable of interplanetary travel?
The Death Star is maintaining a parking orbit between the planet and its moon. If you humans have a starship capable of reaching this apogee, now would be the time to use it. There is the Saturn V moon rocket. It will, however, take several hours to prepare for launch. The city will have to be defended until then.
We don't have several hours. The enemy is at our doorstep. You're asking for more time?
Hey, at least some of us have a moon rocket.
You think you're better than us, Captain Capitalist?
If there's any chance, we have to start moving now.
You talk too much.
Why don't you give the mouth a rest?
If we're fighting among ourselves, we have no chance against...
What country you from?
What?
What ain't no country I ever heard of?
Junior?
Don't call me Junior.
Ugh, blast it. Is there even any point?
Silence. Now, I believe Sally Ride has something to say.
You feel so lost. So cut off. So alone. Only you're not. You see, in all our searching, the only thing we've found that makes the emptiness bearable is each other. Every one of us is, in the cosmic perspective, precious. In 100 billion galaxies, you will not find another. The Earth is where we make our stand. To me, it underscores our responsibility to be more kind to one another and preserve and cherish the only home we've ever known. Don't sit this one out. Do something. By chance of fate, you are alive at an absolutely critical moment in the history of our planet. Our loyalties are to the species and to the planet. Our obligation to survive and flourish is not owed just to ourselves, but also to that cosmos, ancient and vast, from which we spring. We are one species.
A house divided against itself cannot stand. Now we must come together more than ever as brothers and sisters.
Yeah, that's right. Let's come together.
Let's start a revolution.
It's settled then. Nothing but our wit and our will to save the world.
General Zhukov, prepare the wall defenses. Captain America, assemble the Avengers. And Sergeant Pepper, play us something that rocks.
Aye, aye, Captain.
May the Force be with us.
Inspiring words, Sally Ride.
I stole that from Carl Sagan.
Mr. Spock, Sally, you two come with me. You will be needed for our space mission.
One stage of your journey is over. Another begins.
Get to your ship. I will prepare the city defenses. There is no time to lose.
Sally, you will fly as mission specialist. Your task is the arming and deployment of the bomb.
Understood.
Coming from the future, I know advanced alien science, but not your primitive computers. I will fly as assistant science officer.
So the bomb will be loaded into the payload bay. What are we flying? An Apollo lunar lander? This technology is over 50 years old.
An Apollo 18 mission was planned for a seventh moon landing. However, NASA suffered severe budget cuts and the mission was scrapped. This spacecraft has been ready to fly for half a century.
Well, Commander Armstrong, if you flew one of these to the moon, I'm sure you can get us to that Death Star.
As much as I'd like to, I'm too old to fly. To put forth our best chance, your mission commander will be the best young hotshot pilot in the galaxy.
Hey! I'm Ben! But you can call me Benny, and I can build a spaceship! Watch this!
Well, he certainly has energy.
He's eccentric. But he's the best we've got. The rocket is being carried to the launch pad now. The fate of the world rests in your hands, Apollo 18.
Robin, it's Bruce, man. Just come down to the city wall. Something big is about to go down.
No, you can't bring the Teen Titans.
You cannot tell me what you want. Show me a home where the buffalo roam.
Hold your ground. Hold your ground. I see in your eyes the same fear that would take the heart of me. I see a beautiful city and brilliant people rising from this abyss. Be watchful, stand firm in the faith, and act like men. Be strong, let all that you do be done in love. You have the love of humanity in your hearts. Soldiers, don't fight for slavery, fight for liberty. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight on the seas and the oceans. We shall fight in the air. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. Let us fight to free the world, to do away with national barriers, and to do away with greed, with hate and intolerance. Let us fight for a world of reason, a world where science and progress will lead to all men's happiness. Soldiers, in the name of democracy, let us all unite!